Hi everyone. Today we are going to show you the single instance module frontend section. In our last video, we show you the single instance module admin section, where we create the form, validate it, and submit to the database. Today, in this documentation, we will show you the frontend code of the single instance module. You can download the modules which we created, which is the login modules, and you can install it. For that, you can just click the download, save it, and once you download, you can just upload from here, and it will show you the login modules OC mode.zip here. Then you go to the extension modification, refresh it, go to the extension modules, then go to the login, then you can click the install and click edit and enable and save. After that, go to the design layouts, I am showing that login modules in the contact page, so go to the contact layouts and edit and put it in the left section, login. Click add modules and select the login and click save. Once you do that, you can see the login module in the left column, as we added in the left column. So we are going to create this frontend section. Now let's have a look in the code of the single instance modules. So go to catalog, as this is our frontend code, so it should be inside the catalog and controller extension modules and whatever the file name is. So we make a login.php. As our file is login.php, so class name need to be controller extension modules login, and which extends the controller base class, and then create a index method, public function index. An index method is called automatically if there no parameter is passed in the URLs. So you can go to our previous videos where we defined a lot about the URLs and the routings. Here the difference between the single instance and multi instance modules is in the index method. Multi instance modules index method is something like public function index, and which has a parameters of settings. We will go through in detail after this video about the difference between single instance and multi instance modules. So now after that, we create this index methods, we load the language file which we created, like in language e and sgb, extension modules, and login.php. As it's login.php, so we load the language like extension modules login. With this, all the variables which are in the login.php, like text login, text registered, and its values are accessible in the Twig files. We want to show the form only for the customers which are not logged in. So as we defined in our previous videos, how we can get the global methods for the customers and for the other datas, so we can get the get like this in Opencart, whether the customer is logged in or not. So we assign this data to in log data. And these are the URLs that it's set for the actions, like when someone submit the form, and this is for the register URL. This is for the forget passport URLs. This is to set the redirect so that when someone is logged in, then they will get redirected to that page. Similarly, when someone did some mistakes, then it will redirect to the login page. So our modules is little simple. So if someone did it mistakes here, they don't give the proper email address or something and logged in, it does not stay there, and we have not implemented the Ajax and those things. It redirects to the main login page. For the easiness, we implement the modules like that. So that is the redirect sections, redirect URL that we add in here. And this is to add the success message when if someone gets successfully entered. And this is to check if there is a post value of email is set. If not, then it is empty. Similarly, it is to check there is a post value of a password is set, and if not, then it is empty. And we just load the view section. So our view section is at view theme default template extension modules login.twig. So here we simply check if not logged in, then only we show this div or form, and the action is the action URL, which is the login. So that's why it redirect to that login page. If something is incorrect, or when both the email and password is correct, then it directly log in and go to the dashboard. When it is a successful, then it directly go to the dashboard, or if there is any redirects, then it goes to that redirect page. So here is the login. Let me change this to the text, which is text login. So our text content login, which is text login. So we add the text login here. And this is the email sections. Email sections. This is the password section, and the submit button. And if there is any redirects, that we need to go to that page, then the redirects is here. So this will show the form. And when someone submit, then the action takes you to the login controller, because our action is account login, and all the processing is done from the account login. So for easiness, we did it that. But the main purpose of this tutorial is to show how we can create the front end section of the single instance modules. So just create the class, create a function with the index without any parameters, and process your logic here, call the view section and add the view section here. Whatever you want, you can show in the front end section. Like this way, you can create the single instance modules of the Opencart. And in our next video, we will show you the difference between the single instance modules and multi-instance modules. Hope you like these videos. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more upcoming Opencart video tutorials. And you can follow us in Twitter and Facebook as well. Thank you, and happy learning.